Welcome to Morgellons Discussion and Microscopy Videos with your host, Jeremy Murfree.
Hey YouTube, thanks once again for tuning into our show, Morgellons Disease Discussion and Microscopy Videos. Today we're going to be talking again about the antibiotics and how they work and why they work on Morgellons. First of all, understand that people that don't want you taking antibiotics, they may have had a bad experience with the antibiotics. I mean, they suck. They're no fun to take. But the fact is, that's really the only thing that kills bacteria. You know, you have your natural antibiotic compounds, cannabidiol oil and other things, but for killing and targeting specific pathogens, yeah, really all we've got are these 60-year-old antibiotics, and they do make a difference. I've got before and after pictures of my legs, and they look good. They look a lot better than they did before I started, that's for sure. Antibiotics, they really need to be changed up because the bacteria do get adapt to the particular antibiotics you're taking, and sometimes they de-adapt. You can take them again several months later and they'll be effective again. The biggest thing with the Morgellons is it's a chronic bacterial infection. Much like eczema, it causes bacterial biofilms inside the skin. People are confused about what a biofilm is because there are people out there confusing the truth about what that is. Biofilms are not the when you have sores sometimes it'll create a like a gelatinous yellow coating, and people have confused that as biofilm. That is not the biofilm. The biofilm is actually deep inside the sore. Deep inside the skin, there is literally a little structure that bacteria have created to live inside of and to shield themselves from the antibiotics that are going into your bloodstream. That's called biofilm. It's a colonization of bacteria inside your body. Sometimes they can hit up inside a heart valve. They may be able to get inside if you broke your leg or something. They can jam up in there. Most common place you get biofilm is it's the plaque on your teeth. If you scrape that stuff off and put it under a microscope, you're going to see little critters in there because that's what they do. They get onto your teeth and they go, wow, this is great. We get water and food. Hell, we're going to live here. That's why you get your teeth cleaned every few months, or supposed to, you know, take that health care and go down the street and do that stuff. But anyways. So I saw a video today. My friend Angel on YouTube was asking, saying that Candy Griffin Vandewalker had said that do not take antibiotics because they cause the, I don't know what the hell she's telling people, nanobites to freaking replicate. That's not the case. Bacteria replicates by binary fission generally. Yeah, it splits itself in two and that's how it creates more of itself. And to kill those germs, you have to hit them with the antibiotics. You have to hit them with the right antibiotics at the right time, at the right frequency. You can take too many antibiotics and hurt yourself. You can take a light load of antibiotics and just end up making the antibiotics, making the germs strong if you're not taking the right kind of antibiotics. You make your immune system weaker and have no effect on the germs, or you have a good effect on the germs, and the die-off releases toxins into your system that makes you even sicker. So you may think that it's not having any effect, but actually the die-off of the germs that is involved with Morgellons disease do create toxins inside your body. This is called the Herxheimer effect. I didn't used to buy into it because I thought that, you know, if you were killing off the germs, hell, you ought to be feeling better. But, you know, if you kill off the germ and it shits out a toxin after it dies, then yeah, that will make you sicker. And it does feel like butt. But it's something you got to go through if you want to chip away at the biofilms that are causing. Yeah, because in these habitats, that's all they do is replicate. You know, they replicate and they literally pop the top off their home and they flood your bloodstream with all new pathogens, you know. And we are talking about Lyme bacteria, Borrelia burgdorferi, B31. Talking about Bartonella, the cat scratch disease. That's way too common. I'll probably get that from my cat just by playing with them on the floor. Anaplasmosis is kind of common. I had a theory about the chain of pearls. spirochete, but we're going to do some more research on that. Babesia is really common, and I guess malaria is common around here too. But both of those are blood parasites. They literally crawl inside your red blood cell and they eat it from the inside out. It leaves you feeling like you can't breathe and stuff. Anemic as well. So, look, you got a whole lot of pathogens, and believe it or not, they like to cohabitate with each other. Yeah, those little structures that they build inside your body, up under your skin. Typically, it's about 6 different species of bacteria that cohabitate inside that structure with each other, and you know, they delegate various tasks and they even communicate with each other. That's called the quorum sensing. So yeah, there's a lot going on with your body, but in regards to the Morgellons disease. But anybody who tells you that don't do antibiotics, that the antibiotics are going to hurt you, you have to do antibiotics for Morgellons. Morgellons is a chronic bacterial infection. That's it. But you need a competent doctor. You need somebody who knows what pathogens they're dealing with, which means they're going to have to have done their own outside research, because I'm sorry, but medical school just does not cover this. The CDC has totally dropped the ball on Lyme disease. And you're going to have to find a physician who may be open to learning new things together with you. But bottom line is that the science has proven, without a shadow of a doubt, that Morgellons is associated every single time with chronic bacterial infections. Every single Morgellons patient, if we took a scraping off their sore and ran a PCR analysis on it, it would show the DNA of these common bacteria that are plaguing our society today. To deal with those pathogens, you are going to have to get on some Western medicine. I myself try to have a healthy balance of both, and a healthy balance of good lifestyle, if possible. People try their hardest to stress me out all the time and not be on my team. But you know, you got to push through that bullshit and take control of your life. And that means, yeah, you know, doing a little bit of the Eastern philosophy, some of the supplements. When I got into the genetic testing, I discovered the MTHFR, SLC, 19A1 mutations, CYPD2D6, all these things that made me reconsider what I was taking, what I was putting into my body. And making those changes has had positive effects. You know, I am a lot better health-wise than I was 3 years ago, but I'm 3 years older, and I'm a middle-aged man. I need to have the best health care that I can get, you know? And that's just going to be working smart and making the money I need to pay these bills that's going to accomplish and achieve the health that I hope to have. You know, or maybe I'll just get healthy on my own and won't have to worry about any of that mayhem. I don't know. What do you think? Leave a comment down below and let me know what your thoughts are, YouTube. If you like my video, hit that like button, smash into the subscribe, and hit the bell icon, and we can always keep up to date on the latest and greatest Morgellons disease, microscopy, and discussion videos.